So, good evening, students. This is your Devdeep sir, back with lecture of 12 Humanities for History, Bhakti and Sufi Traditions, Part 4. Now, we will first discuss the patronage of the Chola rulers. So, Chola rulers were one of the most remarkable rulers of the south, we all know that. So, they made spectacular representation of Shiva in bronze sculpture. What is this sculpture known as? Popularly known as Nataraj. Okay. The Chola king also introduced the singing of Tamil Shaiva hymns under royal patronage, taking the initiative to collect and organize them into a text called Tevaram. So also they brought about a ritual in which the songs dedicated to Shiva were collected in a text called Tevaram. According to inscriptional evidence, Chola king Parantaka had constructed metal images of Appar, Sambandar and Sundarar in the Shiva temple. Okay, so these were the places where Shiva temples were constructed. Appar, Sambandar, Sundarar, where Shiva temples were constructed by the Chola rulers. Okay, these were carried in procession during the festival of the saints. So this Shiva idols would be carried during the procession of the saints. Okay. So this comes to our first homework question. What is Tevaram? What is Nataraj? Give evidence of patronage of the Chola kings. And the other evidence, you can see Brihadeshwara temple, okay, of Tanjavur were constructed, and also the Meenakshi temple were all built by the Chola kings. Okay. Now the Veerashaiv tradition in Karnataka. The 12th century witnessed the emergence of a new movement in Karnataka led by a Brahmin named Basavna. Okay, so Basavna, a Brahmin, led a movement. He was born in 1106 and died in 1168. He was initially a Jain and a minister of court of a Chalukya king. Okay, so Basavna, being a Brahmin, initiated some reforms. His followers were known as Veerashaivs, heroes of Shiva, or Lingats, or the wearers of Ling. Okay, so his followers, they were basically the devotees of Shiva, who was also known as Veerashaiv or Lingayats. Lingayats continue to be an important community in the region today. So Lingayat till date are one of the major communities in Karnataka. They worship Shiva in his manifestation as a ling, and men usually wear a small linga in a silver case on a loop strung over the left shoulder. Okay, so this ling is also worn on a loop in the left shoulder, okay, as a testament that they are followers of the Lingayats. Okay, so now the homework question would be, So these are the questions you have to solve as homework. Now, the Lingayats also had some tremendous belief. Believe that on death, the devotee will be united with Shiva and will not return to this world. Therefore, they do not practice funerary rites such as cremation prescribed in Dhamma Shastras. Okay? Instead, they ceremonially bury their dead. The Lingayats challenged the ideas of caste and the pollution attributed to certain groups by Brahmanas. So that is why most of the Kannada people even bury. Okay? They do not cremate. Because they believe that their soul would never return to earth again. It will be united with Shiva. Alright? They also questioned on the theory of the rebirth. Okay? So please mark all this. This won them followers among those who were marginalized with the Brahmanical social order. So those who were the oppressed sufferers of the oppression of the Brahman social order, they followed the Lingayat tradition. The Lingayats also encouraged certain practices disapproved in the Dharma Shastra, such as post-puberty marriage and remarriage of the widows. So they practiced that. Okay. Our understanding of the Virashaiv is from the Vachanas, composed in Kannada by men and women who joined the movement. So we can find more about the Lingayat or the Virashaiv tradition in the Vachan published in Kannada. Okay. So again, questions coming up. What were the beliefs of the Lingayats? Question number 2. So these will be the questions you have to solve. Now, Basavna is also having an attitude towards. He said that when they see a serpent carved in a stone, they pour milk on it. If they see a real serpent, they say kill, kill. To the servant of the god who could eat, if served, they say go away, go away. So that means what? This showed how empathetic was the Brahmanical tradition. They did not show any sympathy. If they will see a sculpture of a man, they would worship it because we are all mortal forms, okay? But whenever that mortal form becomes of a lower social order, they will neglect them, okay? They will neglect them like anything. So that is what, okay? So, what was Basavna's ideology? Now, religious ferment or religious condition in North India. According to in North India, there was a period when several Rajput state emerged in most of the state Brahman occupied important place. So, in North India, Brahman had a major role. Okay, there was no attempt to question their position directly. At the same time, there were other religious leaders who were critical of the orthodox Brahmanical system. So, the Rajput states gave huge importance to the Brahman because they were also known as the Rajpurohit. But there were also people who were out of the orthodox Brahmanical system, like Nath, Yogis and Siddhas. Many of them were opposed to the Brahmanical system. So if you have any doubts in today's class, feel free to ask questions in the WhatsApp group. I hope you have a nice day. Keep studying the topics nicely.